What's going on, guys? Zach Perney here, and today's video is going to be all about sleep. So whether you are someone who struggles to get to sleep in general, or you just feel like you can implement a few tips to help you sleep better, I feel like this video is pretty much useful for everyone. So, because everyone needs a good night's sleep. Now, before we get into today's video, I just want to give a quick shout out to the sponsor of today's video, and that is Cuts Clothing.
Cuts make my favorite minimalist wardrobe essentials, perfect for casual everyday wear, or even if you want to dress up a little bit. The fabrics are super soft and the quality is just insane. And they're currently having their Black Friday sale right now, guys, so 30% off site wide. If you want to see what the hype is all about, now is a great time to check it out, and the link is in the description below.
So pretty much, I will give you guys 5 tips that will help you get a better night's sleep. Now, this may seem common sense or just intuitive at first glance, but trust me, if you try these, at least one of these, it'll just make a massive difference. So the first tip is to set a time limit as to when you have your caffeine.
Do you set a time limit on when you have your caffeine? Is there a shutoff point where you go, I don't have any after this time, or?
Up until probably I give it about 7 o'clock, right after that.
Yeah.
Like if I have to go to the gym after 7 o'clock, mm-hmm. I wouldn't be taking any pre-workout or any caffeine. Yep. I'll probably go to bed like 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning if I have to take pre-workout.
100%.
Yeah.
That's what people, I swear they do that. These guys expect to be able to go to sleep when they take pre-workout at like 9 o'clock at night, have 300 milligrams, and then expect to have a great night's sleep. Like what would that look like? What would that look like for somebody trying to have a decent sleep after just smashing a double scoop of Pride right before bed? Do you have any before bed routines or evening routines that you've been doing?
I watch OnlyFans.
The Pornhub subscription. Pornhub Plus, that sends Hafey right to sleep. 20 minutes of that, Hafey's good to go.
Yeah.
Out like a champ.
Tip number 2 is to develop a proper evening routine. Now, this is something that I don't think a lot of people do because they think of evening routines, they think of before bed routines, but we'll get to that, that's not it. Evening routine is literally just that. In the evening, it's to wind down, and that's the whole purpose of it. So for me, this is to actually go for just a brief walk at probably around when the sun's starting to go down, so around like 7 p.m., brief walk outside, and then for the rest of the night after dinner, no screens. So you can watch some TV, but just don't have your phone in your face the whole time. So that white light, keep that away. Now, tip number 3 is to develop a before bed routine. Now, this is very important, and I have a very stringent one that I stick to every night. This makes the most difference for me. So pretty much, it's just a series of things that you'll do before bed every single night. And I think that's the key, is to just be very consistent with this. So for me, I'll share mine. It seems pretty random and weird, but it just works for me. So one thing, my phone is on Do Not Disturb pretty much 90 minutes before I want to go to sleep. So I don't just jump in bed ready for sleep. I have this like wind down phase. So I'll get in bed, my phone's on Do Not Disturb so nobody can bother me, and I'll read. I'll read on my iPad on just the black screen so there's not too much light coming in. But that tires me out already and it just lets me kind of wind down and I don't have to think about anything pretty much. I'll also do a quick journal session, just maybe 10 minutes, just whatever that is, of just getting my thoughts out on how the day went, what I kind of want to do maybe the next day. Just a bit of a refresher, so you feel a bit relieved after that. Another one I'll do with meditation. Now, sometimes I do this at night, but sometimes it's in the afternoon. But either way, that's part of my day. I just know a lot of people like to do this before bed. And I'll do a meditation just to help me kind of relax.
Have you ever done meditation?
Look, meditation, I can only last for 3 days.
What do you mean you can only last for 3 days?
No, like I'm meditating
consecutively. As if that's like a bad thing. Like, look, I can only last 3 days. I can only meditate for 3 days straight, guys. Then I kind of need some water.
take a shit.
What do you mean? Oh, you mean 3 days in a row? Like, doing it? Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
So, and after that, like, journals or whatever. You
full blown monk. That's what I was thinking. Yeah. It's a consistency that gets you with that,
yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
Well, the ones I do is around 6 p.m. at night, and this is part of my evening routine, is that just before dinner, pretty much, I'll have a shower, and just before dinner, I'll stay in my room and I'll do the meditation there. So I don't really come out of my room until I've done it. So that kind of forces me to do it. But then also when I actually walk out of my room after my shower and meditation, I feel super chilled. Like I'm just like, that's me winding down. No more work for the night for me, whatever that time is. If it's like 6 o'clock, pretty much for the most part, that's me done. And then the whole night, I'm just like winding down, relaxing on everything. So that's kind of like that's my first step. It's like shower, meditation, and then I'm just chill for the rest of the night. Now, one thing I used to do was watch TV before bed religiously, but I literally found that that actually kept me up and made me a bit more awake. So lately what I've been doing, and this is just something I stumbled upon, but it's completely random, but I listen to an audiobook before bed and you just set a time. Hey, shut up. I'm trying to explain this, shut up. You just set a timer for like 10 minutes before you want to go to sleep and just put on any interesting audiobook. Like I've done heaps. I listened to The Martian, that was like the movie. Lately, Harry Potter. Goblet of Fire, how good. Anyway, it's just something that's like kind of fiction, I think is works well here.
You listen to a lot of audiobooks, isn't it?
Yeah, I listen to audiobooks. Because podcasts will still keep me thinking. Like, I need to do something that doesn't keep my brain like wired. Like even when I read before bed, they're not books like self-help books or motivational books. I can't read
listen
that.
To David Goggins.
This is my point, right? If you listen to a David Goggins before going to sleep, you will actually be wired to run. Yeah. You'll want to do some shit. Like you won't want to go to sleep and wind down. And I noticed this when I was reading books that were like motivational. I'd read them before bed and go, I feel like a piece of shit. I need to go do something because it makes you motivated and pumped up. Yeah. Whereas you read something that's like chilled, like wind down, maybe fiction or something interesting, and you kind of just go, okay, now I can kind of get myself wind down and ready to sleep. I think a lot of people read before bed thinking it's going to do them well, and it just kind of pumps them up a bit. You just kind of listen to the story or whatever it is. So it's one method that I found actually just helps me switch off without thinking, I can't sleep. So even if I wake up at like 3 a.m. and I can't get back to sleep, I just chuck an audiobook on and I just think about, I just relax, listen to the story, and that kind of like, I just fall asleep in about 2 minutes. It's crazy. Tip number four is to exercise daily and get outside if you can. So there's been a lot of studies on this in literature, especially by Andrew Huberman, loves this. He says, get outside first thing in the morning if you can for 10 minutes and get the light in your eyes. Have you heard that about getting the light in the morning to help your body reset? Yeah, legit. Like, so if you get that 10 minutes of pretty much bright light in the morning, as opposed to being in your room, sheltered, blinds down, it signals your brain and body what time it is pretty much. So then you will get tired, maybe, you know, 18 hours later, whatever that is, your body knows it's time for sleep. Mm-hmm. So the sooner you can do that, the better. But most people like living now act like they're scared of the sun. Like they don't even leave their room. It's all dark and it's like the sun is out to get them. So you really want to have that reset and have it functioning to your advantage. So for me, it's to get up and I just walk outside for a little bit, or I'll just sit by a window just to get enough light. And then also exercising. If you exercise daily, it helps your body set the circadian rhythm. So it's not just about burning energy and feeling tired. That's one component. But the next component is actually telling your body that you need to go to sleep at a certain point. So exercise is huge and actually acting as like a signaling factor in your circadian rhythm and what time you should sleep. So it doesn't really matter too much when you choose to exercise. It'll depend on your own schedule, but just try and keep that in every day. Tip number five is supplements. Now, I don't want to go to this one first because people usually would prefer this as like the go-to. It's kind of like a last resort, but there's still things that I found help me drastically as long as everything else is ticked. So if you've ticked all the boxes, you've done everything right, then you want to try some supplements. Here's a few that I liked.
So this is before bed sups for me usually. We have magnesium glycinate. This brand is KAL. Took a while. You see? Two of these. This is pretty much dinner time / before bed, any time after that, really. Also, theanine, 200 milligrams here. Any brand pretty much is good for these. And so far, these are just acting as relaxants pretty much. Like this is very just a chilled relaxant. The magnesium, if you're deficient, you won't be able to sleep very well at all. So I recommend just keeping them in there. So you can take these daily. And then the last one is ashwagandha. I feel like it does help me calm down, and this is pretty much a regular as well. So yeah, one of these. And if I really, really want a deep sleep, like I know I don't have to get up super early, then EHP Labs make a really good supplement, OxyREM, or OxySleep, was it the powder form? OxyREM is the cap form. It's pretty much just a lot of these and it just knocks you out, sleeps deep. But for me, I don't have trouble staying asleep. It's more getting to sleep and relaxing. That's why these ones, little concoction, Perfect.
So guys, that is pretty much it for this video. I did hope you enjoyed this. Like I said in the beginning, there may be some things that you think, oh, I already do that, you know, but just ask yourself if you really, if you could do things better, if you could take a couple of tips out of this video and just try implement them, maybe just one at a time. Just try and develop that evening routine, switch off, wind down, develop that before bed routine. Actually, like, give your body the respect that it deserves when it comes to rest and recovery. So guys, that is it for me. I have absolutely nothing left for you. Like I said, the cuts link will be in the description below. And that is it. So comment below, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and stay massive. I got a fresh cut in the denim. All these sexy jeans in my section. Slide into your DMs in the PM and the AM. Then I slide into your feelings when you see just what I'm saying.